Welcome to Season 1, Episode 6 of Tiger Talk TV by way of Tiger Media Authority on the all-new Jackson Reed High School Network. Today we have a very special show for you here today.
Wait, there aren't enough barriers to show how diverse Jackson Reed High School is in one show.
Did Miss C write the script?
Stop being silly. You know Miss C doesn't have any time to write our scripts.
You know this is our job and salaries are great.
So much for teaching to the test like everyone else. I mean, do we have to get a teacher with industry experience?
Real world connections?
Build a portfolio?
Did someone call me? Is everything okay?
Yes, Miss C!
Okay, just finish.
Ever feel like you're being watched? Let's get right into the introduction of Jackson Reed Special.
What's poppin'? I'm Lucas Sol, your pop culture correspondent. And this week, I thought we could take a look a bit at our history. More specifically, YouTube. What happened to our YouTubers? What does it say about social media? The most recent internet star that took a step back from YouTube was Emma Chamberlain. She recently announced her retirement on her podcast, Everything Goes with Emma Chamberlain. Would recommend, great episode. Seemed to be a shared mentality throughout the YouTube community, including the Dolan twins, Liza Koshy, and Lele Pons. Now, it probably wasn't all bad in every case, like Tana Mojo, the Paul brothers, and even Emma Chamberlain. They all grew and created new companies and new projects. Some even became boxers, Alex Wasabi, the Paul brothers, and KSI. Was it a smart move? Not sure, but chase that bag. Jack Harlow has recently come out with a new album called Come Home, The Kids Miss You. In this new album, he has a track called Dua Lipa. In the song, the chorus lyric goes,
"We interrupt our program to bring you this important message."
He played the song for her so she wouldn't be blindsided. Her comments on the song were, "Hey, it's your song." So he has her blessing. I like the song, it's pretty good. The internet has finally done it. They've turned the least controversial party of the year for celebrities, the Met Gala, controversial. During the Met Gala after party, a video arose of Billie Eilish saying weird as Cardi B was making a speech. Now, the internet being the internet, just ran with it. It was later revealed that Billie Eilish was talking about the people filming Cardi B. They should have just been filming her. Billie even said she was worried that Cardi would see the clips and, the internet being the internet, would make something out of nothing. Cardi says she holds no grudges as she knew she meant nothing malicious. She even went on to call Billie her baby. That's gonna be all for Popping Off this week. I'm Lucas Sol. See you next time.
Hey guys, what's up? It's your boy Donomir, aka Captain Dog. You might know me from the Dudley Report, doing interviews and questions like that. But I'm gonna be expanding my horizon. I'm gonna be doing some music with my own lyrics, my own beats, and a little music video. I'll give you guys a snippet. Here you go.
What? You already know who it is. It's your boy Captain Dog on the beat. You already know. Yeah. It's been a while since I actually rapped on a track, but I'm back for a promo.
Welcome to the Jackson Reed BuzzFeed with Raven. Today we're going to talk about softball. Yesterday, Jackson Reed softball went to the DCIAA Championship versus Bell. The final score was 22-0. I pitched 4 innings with 8 strikeouts. I got the Most Valuable Pitcher of the Year award and MVP award. Stay tuned for more! There was a lot of fundamental softball being played. Everyone was making contact with the ball, making plays, and having so many strikeouts. We are so ready for St. John.
My name is Jamar.
Hey guys, it's Sanai back here with Tiger Productions, and today's fun fact is that
alligators cannot
stick their tongue out.
What I really like about Jackson Reed is that there's a bunch of clubs for you to do here. There's like drumline, anime club, there's also like Asian stuff and also Arabic stuff. So it's really nice. There's a bunch of clubs for you to feel inclusive in, and there's also a lot of sports.
This year, I've been trying to balance being a student athlete and was able to have the opportunity to compete in New Jersey and became an All-American. So an All-American is someone who contests against everyone around America, and the top five are All-Americans. So just being able to qualify was a big deal, but to be able to make it to top five was just huge for my first year. So
there's also a lot of academic benefits here at Jackson Reed. We provide a good amount of AP classes and academy classes for college future things.
Breaking news. My name's Zena, and I'm here to update you about today's most current issues. Trigger warning for my audience, these topics may be sensitive. If you don't know already, a 98-page draft written to overturn Roe v. Wade was just leaked to Political. This is a big deal. We wait for the official ruling sometime in June, but protests have already begun nationwide. Let's talk about Roe v. Wade first. Roe v. Wade was a landmark legal decision issued January 22, 1973, but it protected more than just abortion rights. These are fundamental rights that could be stripped away but literally save lives. And this affects you more than you know. So basically, Roe v. Wade was this umbrella law. It protects rights to abortions, but also the right to privacy for women. It includes the right not to be persecuted and imprisoned for natural miscarriages and stillbirths, the right to obtain C-sections that literally save lives of pregnant women around the world. It also protects women of color and LGBTQ parents from discrimination in the healthcare system, which we all know is still a big issue. And it's possible schools are not doing enough to educate their students. Lately, where the school systems are failing, the people are making up for it. Across platforms such as TikTok, people are using their influence to share and educate young minds, giving new information, updates, taking risks, and sharing cases of injustices, while also encouraging others to take a stand. Although not discrediting these creators, it's always important to do additional research of your own while enjoying the educational content that these people provide. It's a movement on its own, educating the younger generation, because it's us that'll be affected the most, not these old men who think they have a say on what a woman can or can't do with their body. Once again, my name's Lena, and this is breaking news on the all-new Jackson Reed Network. Back to Tiger Media Authority's original scheduled program.
Here at Jackson Reed, I really enjoy the diversity. I feel like it brings a lot of warmth, and it brings an environment to the school that I feel like other schools should really adopt.
Presenting on all the new Jackson Reed High School networks by way of Tiger Media Authority.
What's poppin'? I'm Lukiah Soul, your pop culture correspondent.
At lunch, some kids walked around and they were asking about, or they were giving out invitations to like the Latino and Latina community to help support them and like just get involved with their culture.
Finalmente, so quiero reconocer a Ariana DeBose por ganar un Oscar en su rol de soporte para West Side Story. Go Latinas!
I think Jackson Reed does a really good job with inclusivity within clubs and sports and classes, and especially in clubs specifically, because there's like Jewish Student Union and Arab Student Union, Black Student Union. They have like all different sorts of ways to include everybody in the school and give everybody a chance to like be a part of something and work in groups with people that they relate with, and then also join with other people who might have differences than them.
Jackson Reed's diversity is really, really incredible. We have people from all over the city and all over the area between our staff and our student body. And it is great to see so many different groups of people able to come together and be part of a really, really large, but really, really wonderful school community. One of the things that I love about teaching here is all of the different electives and academies.
I worked with the academies for 25 years. 25 years ago, we had one academy. Now we have eight of them.
Hey guys, welcome back to Flicked Up Fridays. I can't wait to see all your photos from this weekend. Let's get into it. Welcome back, guys, and those photos look really good, and I can't wait to see more next week. Bye.
I think the school getting a new name, Jackson Reed, is exactly what the community asked for and needed.
I think it's great that we're changing the name.
I think it's definitely an honor to two important people
that fought for education at this school.
I think both of the educators chosen for the name are fantastic.
And it is a good representation of what we are trying to achieve here.
Woodrow Wilson High School, as of the 16th of March, has now been renamed Jackson Reed High School. Renamed in honor of Edna B. Jackson, teacher, and Vincent E. Reed, principal of Wilson and later DCPS superintendent. Jackson was the school's first black teacher, and Reed was the school's first black principal. I cannot think of any more deserving educators for the renaming of Wilson High School, said former Wilson High School principal Michael Durso. This new name shines a fresh, bright light on our school, bringing forth the quality and care of our community. The name Jackson Reed allows a fresh start to acknowledge the complications these noble people had to go through for equality, noting that anyone can do the same. Anyone can bring change to the world for the better through perseverance and faith. I encourage you, students, to take this knowledge and go out and be great, bringing the best out of the world.
Welcome to a small part of the Phillips Collection located in Washington, D.C. The beautiful photos in this exhibit were taken by Jackson Reed students. The special thing about these photos was there was no editing. It's completely film, so you were unable to see how the photo would turn out until you actually developed it. And that fact makes capturing these little moments in time quite amazing.
It's okay to need a break. It's okay to take a step back. Just make sure the next step you take is a step forward. We're in this for the long run. Life is a marathon, not a sprint. We need to pace ourselves. We've got time. Find something you enjoy and do what makes you happy. Set a goal for yourself and go after it. You will figure things out. The only things we can control are our effort and our attitude. If we do that, we will get what we deserve. Our hard work will pay off. Just keep taking those steps forward.
Public service announcement. Please be a safe driver. Pay attention to the road at all times. Make sure you stay off your phone and always wear a seatbelt. If you have any type of prescription glasses or contacts, please wear them while driving so you can protect yourself and others. And also, please pay attention to the speed limits. Drive safely.
Welcome to the DIY segment, sponsored by the Youth Traffic Safety Town Hall.
I first started off by applying the headband onto the heater machine. I placed the logo on top of the headband, as you can see. I lined it up perfectly, and then I placed the cover sheet on top. I moved the heater, I pressed enter, I applied pressure for about 20 seconds. Once those 20 seconds are done, I package them.
Accidents can be easily prevented if everyone is more attentive. So next time you're driving or crossing the street, make sure you give your full attention, because doing so can save a life.
Hello, my name is Chloe. I love to dance. Here are some of my moves. Something about me is that my dad is a doctor. Look, here he comes now.
Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Applesmith, Chloe's dad.
I'm a pediatrician. What do you want to be when you grow up?
How you guys doing? So my job title is a behavior tech, but I'm also the ISS coordinator. So I pretty much run the ISS in-school suspension room. We call it ALC, Alternative Learning Center. So that's basically what I do. I run that, make sure we rehabilitate the students back into the school environment. Me personally, I have not had to suspend any students yet. Hopefully I won't have to. I would say building relationships with each of the students. You get to help in different ways. Different people go through different things and need someone to talk to, and I'm always someone that the students are able to relate to. Being as though I'm so young, I can kind of understand where the kids are coming from when they don't want to go to class and things like that. And then you have administrators telling them, go to class, go to class, go to class. And then it's like, oh, I keep hearing your voice. Let me. So I try to bridge that gap between the administrators and the students to where everybody understands that, okay, students don't like being talked to like that. So maybe if I make it simple and make it relatable, then they'll grasp it a little bit easier.
Tiger Productions presents you a 3-day challenge routine. This consists of getting 8 hours of sleep, going outside and walking a mile, learning something new, 30 minutes of physical activities, so like push-ups, calf raises, drink a gallon a day of water, and doing something that you enjoy.
Hello? Yes, I know the school name changed. It's funny, they got a brand expert in the building.
At the Museum of Production.
And don't even know it. It's like, I was waiting for the right time. So this time, please allow me to reintroduce myself.
Been a little minute, I know right now. Time for y'all to know I'm all right now. Been a little minute since the teacher crossed the hall, told Missy Glass, hey, y'all need a pipe down. Why? Bet you can't do it, can't bite my style. Y'all say just scream big, I teach how. Make them all fans, build a brand, got them out. In person, Timberlands,
good life. If they could do it like me, they would've been on BET, you see. Even on Fox TV. In a pandemic, teaching what you see. Like, oh, Green Bay, Washington, don't choose for. I do what they won't do, I know. New York to DMV on the grind. Shaking heads off, I'm on my Amazon Prime. Right time, right time, right time. It's never gonna be the right time, right time, right time. So it's time to get it right.
And just a reminder to remind you guys that here at Jackson Reed, the musical Les Mis is opening this Thursday, May 19th through the 21st, and next week, the 26th to the 27th. Come check it out. And don't forget to check me out at prom June 11th, hosting the Red Carpet Special.